In a recent video, I have made a complete comparison between these three fans. However, in this specific video, I want to show you the whole process, the whole performance review. It's for the nerd in you. Using this anemometer and my iPhone, I was able to measure the airflow and the noise level at 1 meter or about 3 feet. The contenders are the Dyson AM07 at over $300, the Quietset 8, which is the cheapest fan in this comparison at $70, and finally the Dreo Pilot Max, which is a little bit above $100. The first graph is the airflow at 3 feet. All the graph will be at 3 feet or about 1 meter. So here we have the airflow in kilometer per hour versus the speed level. The speed level is not the actual speed of the airflow. It is really the speed level of the fan. So speed level 1, 2, 3, 4. They are not equivalent. So this graph is just to show the range of each fans. What you can see is that the Dreo Pilot Max is in another league. It beats from level 1 to level 12 the other two. The Honeywell and the Dyson are very similar fans. Just look at the maximum speed of the Dyson, which is about, a little bit over 10 km per hour. You will achieve that speed at level 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Between 6 or 7, you will achieve the same speed as the Dyson with the Dreo, but the Dyson would be at maximum speed. And you will see in the next graph that the Dyson will achieve this at maximum noise, which is not the case for the Dreo. Talking about noise, this is the second graph. We have noise in dBA and the speed level. Again, it's not the actual speed, it's really the levels. What you can easily see by this graph is the fact that the Dyson is not a good fan. It's surprising, yeah. They are trying to sell you this fan, this design, the price, based on the fact that it should be quiet. But it is not quiet according to my test. Starting at the 8 level, the Dyson is over 60 dBA, and trust me, at that point, it sounds like a jet engine. It's not only loud, it's also the kind of sound, because of the design of the Dyson fan, it pushes air through that gap at maximum speed, and it makes some not pleasing noise. Now, if you compare the Dreo and the Honeywell, you can see that they are both better than the Dyson. And the Honeywell is like the perfect fan if you like a small breeze with no noise. As you can see, it's really good air. The Dreo is a little bit louder, it's still quite quiet. And you have to remember here that we are producing twice the amount of airflow that we were with the Honeywell. And as we go up in speed levels, now the curves will cross, and now the Dreo become the best fan according to noise. But like I said in the first graph, the Dreo is always pushing more air. So now let's look at the most important graph. I have taken graph 1 and graph 2, merged them together, and we have this. So it's noise level in dBA again versus airflow air. This is the real deal. What you can see here is that, for example, at 8 km per hour, you will have below 45 dBA on the Dreo. You will have about 53 on the Honeywell. And you will have over 55, almost 57, 58 on the Dyson. That is a major difference, major. So what you can see here is the fact that the Dyson is the worst fan, even if it is the most expensive fan. After that, we have the Honeywell, which is middle of the road, but is also the cheapest. And we have the Dreo, which is destroying the other two. With the Dreo, you have maximum power with low noise. It's the dream fan. I haven't tested all the fans on the market for sure, but I'm flabbergasted. Is it a word? I'm really flabbergasted by the Dreo Pilot Max. I'm totally honest here. On that note, please check my full comparison video on the left or my playlist on the right. Thank you all. It was Tech Dad. Think about liking this video. Ciao.